Hello everyone and welcome back to the video. Today we're doing a 1v4 on Arena and we're playing up against, well first there's me, 2795, don't want to flex, rank 1 currently, oh my god, huge. Then we got Don't Forget to Build Villagers at 1350 team game rating, but actually very good win rate. Then we have Rio G's Move in Silence Like a Lasagna, okay, 1200 elo, Don't Forget About Imperial, 1000 elo, Aweba. No games played. Okay. I negotiated. This guy goes random. I take Ethiopians. These three only know one civ. We're only playing 200 pop arena. So I don't get any extra pop in this game. That was the negotiations. That's what we landed on. But usually arena is like unwinnable. So let's see if I can get in here. I picked Ethiopians because I wanted to get off to a really nice boom. All right. He got Sicilians. That's completely fine. I want to get off to a really nice boom and then try to carry with Arbalest Halb, something like that. I noticed they don't really have good answers to Arbalest if I can take out the Vietnamese first. Also, the volume is way too loud. Okay. There we go. Perfect. If I can kill the Vietnamese guy first, then I think they don't really have a lot of options for like Arbalest. So that's kind of the theory over here. But let's see if that actually, works out well. It's unclear so far. I have so many gates. Okay. I recommend you do that, by the way, on Arena. It's not for no reason. You do that to get more space, and you do it at the start of the game where not much is going on. Because if you don't do that, and like later on you need like a wood line that's behind walls, you're going to be like just feeling terrible about it. Or if you want to expand or run, add some farms there. You want to clear up your space in Arena. But anyways, 1v4 got Ethiopians. One thing you can do which is really cool with Ethiopians is actually go up to Castellage without making a mining camp. That's actually really, really nice. It doesn't sound like a lot, but it basically saves you 100 wood. And it saves you a lot of that walking time towards the gold and actually, you mining the gold. It's quite a big deal. I also might lure the boars with my scout in this game. And I'm going to let you in on a quick little secret. So if you guys watched Hidden Cup, you'll know that I always lured the boar on the map called Evacuation. Now you might be wondering why or how I only lured the boar by taking only one hit. So that was obviously something we practiced. And the way to do it consistently is to hit the boar from the back. And then before you land the second hit, you want to run back as soon as you can. Like this. And then you run back right away. And you see how the second hit of the boar kind of glitches out. It's actually somewhat difficult to do this. It takes some practice and you could mess it up. But if you practice it a lot, you'll get to the point where you can lure boars with scouts by only taking one hit, by hitting the boar from the back and running away really fast after you deal that second hit. Because to lure a boar, all you have to do is hit the boar twice. The boar does not have to hit you twice to follow you. So that's kind of something you need to know. Next foe can make a house and a mill, maybe even two houses. No, I just try to do as good of a build as possible. It's like kind of the best thing I can do in a way. I am in a 1v4 arena situation. This is not easy. But yeah, it's nice to get that tip out there. It's actually not very known. Like, actually, MBL, I think, knew about that for a long time because he always did it like that. But he never told anyone. He just keeps it hidden. That's why I think, like, not gonna lie, you guys on YouTube... You guys are looking to have me being so stupid. I'm way too stupid. I give away all my secrets right away. You guys are lucky I'm stupid like that. If I was smart, I'd keep everything hidden to myself and I'd get an unfair advantage. Well, it's not unfair, but I'd get an advantage. MBL was keeping it hidden, but we found a secret and now it's out there. And now, I know MBL. I know his dirty little secret. We'll do it again. All right, it's hard to do, so I hope I don't mess up. All right, there we go. Sick. I mean, it's not that hard, but like, it's somewhat difficult. The thing is, even if you mess it up, you just take a second hit. So it's not like the end of the world. So even if you mess it up, you just take one extra hit, then it's fine. But as you can see here, if I didn't use that trick, I would be at 5 HP, taking two hits from each boar. Now I'm at 25 HP. So now it's actually kind of, completely fine. You can use that trick to lame enemy boars, to steal or to lure your own boars on arena or islands or whatever. Registered Fortress. It's a really good trick to know about. And hey, even if you don't want to do it yourself, you just know about it now. Why not? Why not expand that AoE knowledge? We're going to go up as fast as we can. I think we're going to try a 23 pop. That leads into a 3 TC boom pretty comfortably, I believe. 23 pop, that's 22 bills. Okay. Pretty chill. There we go. Nice. Also, it is worth mentioning, you guys have seen me using the new buttons here as well, the auto drop-off and stuff. Those buttons are really good. Both new functions, the Seek Shelter and the auto drop-off, are both amazing buttons. Definitely use them. I made a video on my Patreon right away when they first came out. To kind of explain how you want to be using them. But yeah, the gist of it is they're really strong. And you definitely want to be using them as much as possible. I personally have gotten to the habit of using the auto drop-off button. And I'm getting into the habit of using the Seek Shelter button. They're both really good. Definitely must use. Alright, it should be like a pretty close to perfect build. Yeah, that's pretty close to perfect. Nice. Okay. Let's cut the map a little bit. Dude, their names are so long. They have some funny names, though. Ryoji is moving silence like lasagna is crazy. That's actually insane. It's such a good name. Dude, I'm actually a huge fan, man. Alright. That actually might be the best name I've ever seen. God, I'm like overplaying it now, but... No! What the hell? Don't forget to build those. Don't forget about Imperial. These guys are like, they're watching my coaching session and then making accounts. With the tips I'm giving out. Nice. Always two bills on market, one on blacksmith, and they both finish exactly when you make the two bills. These two bills I make and I send them straight to wood. I get double bit axe early if I can afford it. If not, I'll just cancel it. I don't think I can, so I'll probably just cancel it. Yeah, screw it. If you have like extra food for whatever reason and you can get it early, you definitely get it early. It's just efficient. If not, two bills. And these guys will finish at perfect time. Done. Up. Perfect. Like, you just follow the exact build order, the exact strategy, and you'll get these same times. Alrighty. I'm a huge fan of practicing that Dark Edge. Alright, there we go. I mean, it's the best thing you can do. Like, I used to suck in Arena, and I realized one of the reasons I used to suck in Arena is simply because I didn't have a good Dark Edge, a good build. I didn't set myself up for success. Now I realize, you know, there's not much to do on Arena. Make sure every village is working perfectly. Like this guy, bro, fix that guy. Fix him. There we go. Make sure you got a good start in. And just to make sure I get horse collar farms in there. Not sure what to do with the scout. Like, ideally I want a scout, but I don't want to lose him either. So I think I'm just trying to keep him inside my base. Because if they catch me, they just kill me every time. Not much I can really do about it, so I just keep him right there. I got to find my TC spots. One here is perfect, and one here. Oh, okay, perfect. We have that done. Utilage, a little late there. I'll for sure be the first guy to castle. I don't think anyone is beating me. With this build, I'm 23 pop Ethiopians. Plus two, it's really fast. Alright, now what we want to do is take three off there and take 30 gold. That 30 gold, you're going to buy either food or wood, and it's going to help you develop with Ethiopians as well. And then you want to pick up both booming upgrades if you want to. You don't have to. There we go. If you want to know more about booming, I do a full guide, including when to get every eco upgrade in the game, on my Patreon as well. That's kind of where I have the in-depth guides. The guides basically that wouldn't do well on YouTube. If I post that video on YouTube, it doesn't get that many views because not everyone cares. for the kabooming guide. But for those who do care, it's gonna be amazing. So now we buy this, helps us get that. There we go. And now we're all set. Yeah, we're gonna suffer a little bit of idle time here. This is completely, completely normal. There's not much you can do to avoid this idle time. Have that finished before heavy plow, damn it. If you squeeze in heavy plow, you cannot avoid this idle time with most sips. It's very difficult. But I do think it's somewhat of a fair trade for heavy plow. A little bit of idle time. There might be a better way to do it that I'm not aware of. Maybe upping one pop later and not forcing it, but I still think this is a really good way to do it. If you want the heavy plow again, you don't have to take it. It's just optional. I like it though. Nice. Do that. That's really good. Yeah. I wonder if I could have seen that castle. Now I have to react to it. I mean, if I die to the boom or to the castle drop, then it's fine. Like the boom. Yeah, it's like I have to boom anyway because I can't make army anyway versus this. I have to boom and defend with monks now. All my golds are forged, just kind of bad. So let's go ahead and make a mining camp here. Try to react to this. We have to first start with the monastery. It's number one defensive tool. So judging from the scores, I think yellow is definitely the weakest. So that's good. He is Vietnamese. He's the guy that has the answer to like the Arab Bless. So he's going to be the weakest. That's actually great. I'm not Ashley House. That's fake. Yeah. Let's get the wheel now. Now we get the monastery. Sneak that in. I think he used a petard there or what? The thing is, it's not that scary because even if he brings in like what sergeants, it's fine. Like they're not that scary. What I'm scared of is like knights running in or something. It would be very deadly. All right. Yeah, now we can start taking a little bit of stone. Starting to lag a little. I'm not a fan of that. Because usually when it lags, that's all my advantage gone. Yeah. Don't want to be lagging in these games. We'll just heal the scouts. Probably can't do 4 TC, so we're just going to do 3 TC into castle, into imp, something like that. That's completely fine. We'll just convert that guy. Yeah, I'm here. Yeah, nice. Let's get a couple of those guys in there. Oh, he thought I was one hit, but I healed. Can I use the conversion that I charged up to get an instant convert? The bill. Oh, nothing. Okay, nothing. That's fine, that's fine. That's probably enough farms. Now we gotta click up the imp as soon as we can, I think. I need to push this and start doing some real damage. I need to kill them fast. And I'm planning to like forward castle one of them right away. Maybe one castle at home, or maybe not. Maybe I just move out with bomber cannons to break the castle. Alright. I need a castle drop one and literally erase them from the map. Because it's arena, so we can pin them in real easy. And if I don't do that, I'm going to get overwhelmed for sure. Especially since I'm not playing a mobile unit, right? Playing crossbow. Yeah. Also, by the way, I hope you guys appreciate that I'm mixing up the civs for these 1v4s. Like, obviously, the civs I play are not exactly the best civs for the situation, but I mix them up as much as I can because I want you guys to be able to enjoy multiple of these in a row without seeing the same civs over and over again. I hope that's something you guys, you know, like. If you guys want to see me pick the best civ every single time, then let me know. I can adapt. That's nice. Heal up. But I always make sure to pick a decent civ. Alright, now that the barracks is being complete, we get ballistics, get armor. Armor is not the most important, but I like the first one because it's so cheap. 100 food, you barely feel it at this stage. It's funny, 100 food at the start of the game is amazing. 100 food now? Who cares? This is the weakest player on crossbow ready, so okay, he's probably just out of the game right now. Just because he's making crossbow, which is delaying his economy, and he did nothing with the crossbow, so that's actually not a worry of mine at all right now. That's how it works in team games, by the way. Like, if you see some guy making army, I know, like, a lot of people in, like, mid-elo team games and stuff, they see a guy booming and they're like, oh my god, he's booming, make army, you're so bad, you're a noob, all you can do is boom. They always talk like that, right? I see it. It happens all the time. But a guy booming is the biggest threat, okay? Like, if the guy is booming, that means he is super, super dangerous, and you have to address that as fast as you can. If the guy makes army and does nothing with it, he's just kind of setting himself behind for no gain. And I don't consider those a threat at this point. So get chemistry right away. Nice. Start making your army. I want to drop a forward castle. I don't want to do a single castle at home if I can help it. Nice. So that's how, when you decide, like, if you want to carry the game, right? When you decide who you attack. Right now, my list is the two guys that are literally just booming, the top two. This guy went castle drop, so he's further behind. Obviously, he did something with the castle drop. I have to clear it now. So it's not like he wasted his time. But I have to rush to hit the other two, because they got a pure boom. I got a pure boom, so now I'm a demon. The castle drop didn't do much to me. Now I'm really strong. A little bit of lag here, though. Hope that's not too annoying. And now we're at like 100 bills to start moving out. The food we can sell later. Or right now, get cannons. Siege Engineers is crucial. Before Arbalest, because Arbalest doesn't really matter. I'm not really fighting at the moment. This is a good time to get Loom. Good time to get Town Watch. Good time to get this. Yeah, I might kill Orange, because I think that's like one of the strongest players. So I might castle drop him fast and then go to the next guy as the pockets. Should be a pocket here, pocket there, yeah. Alright. I think it's the army we're going to make should be really unstoppable. Like, Arbalest cannons, before they're ready to play, is really strong. It's going to kill them very fast. I need to already get ready with the bills. Monks will stay here in case I get attacked on the stone. In theory, the archers from this player should go here right away, but I don't know what they're up to. Over there. Right, we're just in a race now. Speed run. Basically what it is, if you think about it. Like, I will be stronger than any one of them, but if I don't go fast, I will die to all of them together. Oh, this lag is too annoying. All right, it's enough arbalest here. Let's go here. Nice. Now yellow's moving out. Yeah, this is what I'm looking for. Yellow, you don't want to take this fight, buddy. Trap him. Nice. I have only 200 pops. I have to go quick. I should be dead. Gotta make sure Orange gets defeated here. Defend on his stars. We gotta defeat Orange fast. If I defeat Yellow and Orange, maybe I can 1v2 the other two guys. This is perfect. He has to be defeated though. I hope he didn't run away with anything. Ah, so laggy, man. Nice. Orange was saved. Obviously, I wanted torsion engines as well, by the way, but it was not, there was no time for that. Yellow's defeated, which is good. My defeat of orange did not finish, though. I'm running low on gold. I have infinite gold if I killed. Yeah, yet when yellow dies, right? Nice. Damn, he got my treb as well. That's actually pretty bad. Bad pathing and dead. Classic. This feels a bit cruel in the bottom. Just business, my bro. Engines would be nice, but it's just a luxury I can never afford. Now I think I'm in like a 1v2 situation. Orange is nearly dead. Paladin now from the Lithuanian supplier. The problem is they're both on cav units, right? Now we got a bit of a scrim switch in. That's a smart choice. I like that, Mr. Hindustani. Oh, he got defeated. Thought he resigned. Okay, defeated. Nice. We got one. Sorry, brother, by the way. By the way, on the fly, sorry. It was really nothing personal. That's... I think we have orange defeated. Oh, but hold on. I think we might still lose. Yo, this could be the craziest game of 1v4 ever. We defeat two and still lose? Orange! No, wait, Orange has skirms. He's still alive. We couldn't defeat him. He ran away with those, damn it. That's bad. He's the strongest player. Oh man, now we're falling apart for real. Try to take some of that gold, keep those guys alive. Why is wood so expensive? Yeah, Orange is taking a lot of damage, but he's not actually gonna get defeated. I think I have too many farmers to take some of farm into wood. Yeah, Sicilian imp scrims are just as fine as well. I mean, they're not. They're not the Vietnamese ones, but they're fine. They do the trick. This is where I wish I had the extra pop. This is where it hurts. Got a sneak attack here with just some siege to kill that. Good, now they got imp scrims. Oh, that's crazy. I don't think we can win anymore. This is where Ethiopians fall off. I had to defeat Orange. I cannot be wasting any pop on Orange. Failed castle. I have Sertels that I can go for. Oh, I didn't get that ever. Nah, shit, that was one cut. I have Ankit in here. Wow, yeah, we got bested here. Little bit of early GG, but I don't see how I can come back here. They have two guys fully boomed. Really good comp as well. So even though we defeated one player, I couldn't quite defeat Orange. And look at that, he's already freshly reboomed back here. So well played there to escape. Thought I could trap him and defeat him. Maybe I need to be quicker to wall this, but he just played it well and left. I mean, my strat worked, but maybe targeting yellow was not the call. Maybe targeting someone else, but it's hard. Like, I have to target the person closest to me. Just so happened that yellow was their weakest link. So he kind of took one for the team. He's defeated, but honestly, he's the one getting the last lap here. Defeated, but still gets the win. Either way, GG well played. This is a really good game, though. One of the better 1v4s. Unfortunate about the lag. Hope you guys don't mind that too much. Obviously, it definitely hurts me the most because I have to micro for four players. But yeah, GG well played to these guys. Nice name, Mr. Purple. And make sure to like, comment, subscribe if you guys enjoyed it. One more look at the stats. And I'll see you guys next time. Take care and peace.